Hi, I'm Rashaan Allwood, and welcome back to Organist Launchpad. I'm really excited for this presentation where we're talking about arranging popular music for the organ. And I'm here with Cadence, who's performing one of her own original arrangements.
Hi, my name is Cadence Brassard. I'm a 14-year-old organist, and though I love playing classical music, I also enjoy arranging popular music for the organ.
All right, so why don't we jump in to your arrangement? Nice, that was awesome. Yeah, it's so fun to hear the different styles on the organ. And I really love a lot of the sounds you're getting out of it, out of the organ, and I like a lot of the figurations. So first I wanted to talk about, it's nice that you took it from the like a piano voice arrangement, because that's common for transcriptions, even like transcribing orchestral music and stuff. It can be useful to work from a piano arrangement, right? And it works so perfectly because you have your voice part. This is like your third manual. So that's that, you know, that's great thinking on that. So one thing I was thinking is that we can borrow from like the Baroque Wayu Men sense, you know, like when they're trying to imitate the human voice, they use the reed and some tremolo and stuff like that. So we can do that maybe a little bit when the melody comes in, so we can differentiate between the intro sounds and then the solo sounds. And but it's hard because you have to get a loud sound. So why don't we look at that first piston there? And what are you accompanying the melody on?
So I'm accompanying, so like the left hand with the chord hits, that's on the bottom end.
Nice, nice, yeah. So we could put it like, why don't we like kind of, we'll set it to somewhere different, but why don't we do it maybe on the swell so you have something kind of quiet?
Okay. I'm coming off of the swell in another part, coming down off of here, then it goes to there, then it kind of does a step down.
Right, then you come down, yeah, exactly. So, but what you can do is when you start the melody, you can go to a quieter accompaniment. So you can do your crescendo for the intro, which I really like, and then you can switch, maybe have a piston switch right here.
Okay.
And then we can set something up for this melody.
Okay.
So let's, like, just for fun, like, let's try something. So accompaniment-wise, let's go on the swell. Let's just, like, cancel for a second here. And maybe something else I was thinking is we can use a lot of string sounds, like Celeste sounds, because, you know, when I think of theater organ, or I think of a Hammond, or I think of a Leslie, you know, that shimmering quality is, like, so important. So we can throw that in. So if we're going to accompany... Maybe if that's too quiet, we can super couple it. So we can find our swell four. You know, that might work for accompaniment. We'll see, we can try it. And then for a solo, maybe the clarinet I know is pretty quiet. But it could work actually. Why don't we try, and then it'll sound pretty different than what you're used to. We'll put some flutes in the pedal and we'll couple from the swell.
Okay.
Let's just try this bit right here with the melody.
So the hand stack would be like
Yeah,
that
exactly. Okay. Nice. What do you think?
I like that. I think it's very different from what I'm used to.
Very different. Yeah, exactly. Nice, but it's nice to have that color sometimes if you want it.
It's a different variety for sure, but I do like how it really changes the mood a little bit.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. And organ people will hear the reed and they'll think voice or they'll think solo at least, you know? So why don't we try, like, can we set that to 10? Do you have anything on 10?
I don't have anything
on 10. Okay, so I'll just throw it on 10. Let's try your intro, and then I'll hit 10 right here.
Okay.
Or do this on the swell, and I'll hit 10 right there, yeah. Okay. Let's hear it. Let's hear how it works. Yeah, exactly.
Okay.
Or either, because that's not the voice yet. It's still kind of part of the intro. Yeah,
okay.
Exactly. Let's just try like from that moment there. Nice. And let's keep going. Nice, I messed up. Nice, right? So I added a sesquialtera. I meant to actually completely switch it. So that's another thing we can do, like, when you're just trying to be colorful for fun.
Yeah.
When the melody repeats, you can try switching registrations.
Yeah.
You know, you can switch from your clarinet to like a sesquialtera or something. So you have like two different little solos there. You can grab those with divisionals, but I'll grab them for you. Let's try the melody, and let's see how that sounds. Let's start with the cornet, and then let's go right there.
So just the melody or
You can do the left hand too, yeah. And then I'll switch it to the clarinet for you halfway through. Just keep going. Yeah, nice. All right, so yeah, all that to say, you can have a different registration in each section.
Yeah,
you know, you can go crazy.
It makes sense because though, like, kind of repeats in like the musical sense when someone's singing it, then you have the different words.
Yeah, exactly.
You need something else to give it more variety.
Yeah, exactly. That's it. So just throwing in all sorts of, like, that's the thing in transcriptions in general, pop, like I mentioned before, orchestral, whatever. You can kind of go crazy, and there's a sense that you want to show off as many different colors of the organ as possible, right? So in a moment like that, yeah, it works so well to have various different solos. And then here, like you did, you originally had a change here, so that still works. So yeah, I would experiment, right? And on an organ like this, you have so many possibilities, because then you can also do stuff if you don't want to switch... if you don't want to switch pistons, you could just have two different... manuals set up, you know? So you could have that, and then when you switch, you could jump down to that, you know, with the sesquialtera, you know? Mm-hmm. Let's look at a different section. I know you build up, mm-hmm. and so I really like that too.
Yeah, so this kind of takes a bit of a decrescendo here, like it mm-hmm. goes like...
Right.
And then this hand comes in with a bit of like a melody.
The melody, yeah. Let's try, this just happens once. Do we have any like echoing melodies?
It kind of like repeats here.
Okay, let's try this. I know this is a bigger registration, so mm-hmm. let's amp it up.
So do you want me to change to the piston?
Yeah, let's see what you have, right? So you're accompanying with which hand?
So the left hand is on the racy and nice. Or swell, and the right hand's on down here.
All right, let's try a little bit of it.
Sus4.
Yeah, exactly.
So it kind of has that suspension.
Right, right, yeah. I like that part when you were accompanying, you were kind of jumping octaves in the left hand. Can mm-hmm. we go to that part? Where that part is? It's like you're accompanying...
It was this part.
Yeah,
here.
Let's try some of that and just put another read on the solo really quick, just for fun. So that's on 4?
Yeah, that would be on 4.
And then... So what, you're playing the solo here?
Yeah, I'm playing... Yeah, mm-hmm. that's where I am.
Is that it? Is that right? Yeah.
I think so.
Nice. So let's try a little bit of that for 1 second, and then.
Oh, geez. Nope. Sorry. I am like this.
Okay. Nice. Okay. Let's try a little bit of that. Okay. Nice.
Oh, sorry.
There it is. Yeah. Got it. So this part right there, I would put like a trumpet or something. Maybe it's too early for your trumpet, but let's just put it on for fun right now. So that's, we're gonna go, yeah, that sounds like the trumpet, and then let's do this. Yeah, let's try it. Nice, yeah, so just having something to make that melody really audible, mm-hmm. right? So those are the two things about the reed solos and the sesquialtera solos and the trumpet solos, is that they'll really poke out through the texture. Mm-hmm. So when the voice comes in, it'll be really clear for your listener. So yeah, I would experiment with going through, adding some trumpets, some clarinets, some manual changes at some other moments for the melody, just to have fun. And the last thing I wanted to talk about was just adding some electronics and drums, which, you know, we were talking a bit about theater organs and all those things, and they have the drum machines built in. Mm-hmm. You were mentioning that you have a theater organ at home.
Old Rogers.
Nice, that's awesome. And it has some drums mm-hmm. built in. Yeah, exactly. So I think this stuff can be pop music. It'll really scare your audience when you throw in some drums in there, right? And that's why we're doing it, right? To have like let them kind of get a smile on their face at least. So I brought one of my synthesizers in here. It's a Moog Mother 32, and it has some like drum sounds and some snare sounds. So I thought maybe it would be fun to finish off. We can maybe play through it one more time.
Okay.
And I'll just kind of jam along with you on the synths here. So the first thing, we'll just need to establish the tempo. Is that okay? Or should we go a little slower?
A little slower, maybe.
A little slower.
I think there.
Okay, nice.
Okay.
Let's try it.
Okay.
Thank you. Nice. Yeah, that was awesome. Yeah, so I mean, I think you can have a lot of fun with drum machines, stack them up, get some electronics on, throw some solos, and but really it's sounding really great, and I think you should be, you know, really proud of doing this kind of stuff, because I don't know many people that are playing pop music on organ doing these kinds of arrangements, so I think it's really great, so that's awesome.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Thanks for the masterclass.
Well, thank you for joining us for Organist Launchpad and this presentation on arranging popular music for the organ. I'm Rashaan Allwood.
And I'm Cadence Brassard.
And please enjoy some of the other fantastic presentations in the series.